News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil. Joining me today is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hi, Neil.
So what's our story today?
Today's story, Neil, is about a health crisis and a radical measure for dealing with it.
OK, well, let's find out some more about that from this BBC Radio 4 news bulletin.
A minimum unit price for alcohol has come into force in Scotland. The Scottish Government believes it will reduce the harm caused by excessive drinking, leading to fewer hospital admissions and alcohol-related deaths.
So, the Scottish Government is setting a minimum price for alcohol. This means that cheap and high-strength alcohol is going to become more expensive. Now, the reason that they're doing this is because the Scottish Government wants to cut the amount of harm that is done to people's health through excessive drinking.
OK, well, you've been scanning the various news sites for this story and picking out vocabulary that will be useful. And you have three items. What have you got?
We have today, Neil, booze, calls time on, and day of reckoning.
Booze, calls time on, and day of reckoning. So your first headline, please, there with booze in it.
Yes, so we have BBC News. The headline is Scotland ends cheap booze as minimum price starts.
OK, booze, alcoholic drinks.
Yes, exactly that. Really simple. It's very popular with headlines because it's nice and short. We also use it in everyday English. It's a fairly slang word, but it's becoming more and more common and acceptable. Booze means alcohol. It can be wine, whiskey, cider, beer, lager. Anything that you drink with alcohol is booze.
But it doesn't mean when you go to the doctor and have an injection and they wipe alcohol on
you.
That's not booze.
That's not booze, yeah. Cough medicine with alcohol, that's not booze. Nail polish remover, acetone, that's not booze. It's only the alcohol that you drink.
Yeah. And there are lots of versions of this word.
It's actually quite a flexible word, booze. So in the noun form, as a noun, it's alcoholic drinks. You can also use it as a verb, to booze.
He boozes every day.
Boozes every day. I was boozing last night. Mm-hmm. Yes, everybody will be boozing at the party. It means drinking and enjoying drinking. Now, you don't booze when you just have one glass of wine with dinner. Yeah. It's a sort of party word. Mm-hmm. A boozer, a person who drinks, who likes to drink, so mm-hmm. add an R on the end.
Yeah,
and it's also a place.
Yes, a pub.
A pub, yes.
It's a slang word for a pub, a boozer.
Exactly that, yes. So very flexible word.
Also an adjective.
A boozy.
Yeah.
Boozy, yes. If you have a pudding with a bit of often sherry in a cake, mm-hmm. We call that a boozy cake.
Okay, so a very flexible and informal word.
Very flexible and informal, yes.
Let's move on to our next headline.
OK, so now we have the Financial Times. Scotland calls time on cheap super-strength booze. That word again. But mm-hmm. we're looking at calls time on.
Yeah, calls time on, meaning announces the end of an activity.
Yes.
This is a very clever headline, isn't it?
It's pretty good, yes, because they're using a pub phrasal verb to call time on, and they're using the meaning of that verb in their headline. So, talking about alcohol law in the United Kingdom and in Scotland, in this case, there are laws about when pubs are allowed to sell alcohol. A lot of them have to stop serving alcohol at 11 o'clock, and that name is time. Mm.
So I think it's later in Scotland, actually.
Oh, is it later in Scotland? I had some holidays up there.
I have.
Okay. So whatever time it is, at some point, the landlord, the owner of the pub, will call time. And that's when he or she says, everybody, you can't have any more alcohol. So, Neil, would you like to demonstrate? Please call time.
I've always wanted to do this.
Come on, then.
Time at the bar. Time at the bar, ladies and gentlemen. Time at the bar.
And that means you can't serve any more alcohol. So if you call time on something, you say that's the end. It stops.
Yep.
So in this case, Scotland calls time on cheap alcohol. But you can use it in your everyday English to say, I'm going to stop doing this activity, or I'm going to stop somebody else doing that activity
yep.
For example,
I'm going to. I really want to call time on the internet.
Yeah, you're overdoing it.
I just, you know, I spend all day at work in front of a screen. When I get home, I don't want to do it anymore. I'm going to call time on the internet.
Very good. I'm going to call time on Rob stealing my biscuits. I've had enough. Enough is enough. I'm going to call time on it.
He's terrible, isn't he?
He's awful. He thinks we don't know, but it's kind of obvious.
It is.
One thing other to say about to call time on is it's usually you call time on an activity which is damaging in some way, a bad habit, something that you want to stop. Mm-hmm. So, yes, too much internet, too much biscuit stealing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that preposition on is important.
It is. You call time on the activity, and the activity can either be a noun or it can be a gerund.
So I'm going to call time on smoking.
Yeah.
Or I'm going to call time on cigarettes.
Yes, exactly that.
OK, our final headline, please.
Right, let's go to the Herald. The headline is Herald View, Day of Reckoning for Alcohol Policy.
OK, Day of Reckoning, a time when you have to deal with a past mistake.
Yes. Yes. So something happened in the past and now it's time, something usually bad. Mm-hmm. Now it's time to look at it and deal with it. It comes, it has religious origins, this phrase. A lot of religions believe in the judgment day when you die and you have to explain the way you lived your life and you will be punished or rewarded for this. That day is called the Day of Reckoning. And so we're using it here in a non-religious sense to say that alcohol, this old alcohol policy is now going to be kind of judged and changed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you're having a bit of a day of reckoning with your garden.
Well, my garden's in a bit of a mess, I've got to say. So I'm going to go out there and deal with it. I'm no more messy garden. It's the day of reckoning this weekend.
Right.
I'm going to be out there with all the tools and the equipment, digging and cleaning. Yes.
You will be judged for not getting that lawnmower out earlier.
Not anymore.
Finally, we have our recap of vocabulary. But before that, of course, we have our social media challenge. And we asked a very simple question, actually. The pub is a British institution. But what is pub short for? Is it A, public drinking, B, public house, or C, public bar? What was the response?
Quite mixed this week, Neil. I think you caught quite a few people out. The correct answer is actually B, public house. The origins of this is when alcohol a long time ago was brewed and sold in people's private houses, but they got a license or they were allowed to invite people into their house to drink and buy the alcohol. So that house then became known as a public house. So well done to on Facebook, Omni Coulson Collie, who said answer B, public house. On Twitter, Kissy Fur got the correct answer, public house, pub. And Instagram, we had Femedieva, who said a public house, which has an establishment licensed to sell alcoholic drinks such as traditional drink, beer and cider.
Well done to everyone who got that right. And now just a recap of our vocabulary, please, Catherine.
Certainly. Booze means alcoholic drinks. Calls time on means announces the end of an activity. And the day of reckoning is a time when you have to deal with a past mistake.
If you would like to test yourself on this vocabulary, there's a quiz you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where you can find all kinds of other videos, games, activities to help you improve your English. Thanks for joining us and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.